In today's video, I'm sharing three tips or tricks that relate to strokes in Adobe Illustrator. I'm pretty sure you're going to at least learn something new about strokes when working in Illustrator with today's tutorial. As a graphic designer, it's crucially important to have a space on the internet to showcase your portfolio of work. Bookmark offers a straightforward and an easy to use website solution where you don't even need to type out a single line of code. Check out Bookmark linked down in the description box below and design your website today. So with the first stroke tip, we have a simple square with a simple stroke, you know, pretty basic stuff. We can edit the stroke weight and also the color within the color palette. However, there is one aspect of Illustrator that is so powerful when it comes to strokes that you need to learn and you need to use this in your workflow, and that function is the appearance panel. Now, I've spoken about it before, but to really show you the real power of the appearance panel in terms of strokes, I've made a second square right here. So firstly, we can drag and move strokes behind or in front of the main fill. This is something you cannot normally do without the appearance panel. You can then also increase the stroke weight here, which is handy and convenient. And you can even change the opacity of the stroke in this menu as well as having access to other options too. Now remember, I have two more tips coming, but the next powerful aspect for the first tip is that the appearance panel, you can actually add as many strokes as you want to in one design object. You can rearrange their order and change their weight and their color and everything else that I just spoke about. The other awesome feature here is that you can add effects to your strokes alone from the appearance panel. So let's go ahead and add a Gaussian blur to our new blue stroke. So there's the first tip, and let's move on to the second Illustrator stroke tip effect. So here's a logo design I recently made for a client, and they 100% wanted a chess related theme, and also I made some custom logo type for the logo as well. The stroke tip here involves the two chess pieces. I wanted to make a cutout line so one piece appeared in front of the other, and so you think you'd simply just add a white stroke, right? Well, no, because the logo itself will then have a white stroke on any color background. And to demonstrate this, let's take these two circles. If I overlay them and then add a stroke to one of the circles, it looks good on the Illustrator artboard. But it wouldn't work as a logo on a background. So one workaround here is to first select all of the objects and then expand them. And once they've been expanded, you can then go ahead and use the divide function in the Pathfinder panel. This is going to essentially split every single vector component into an individual shape, so you can then remove the stroke sections that you don't want. This is one way to work around this workflow, and of course there are many different ways to do things in Adobe Illustrator. The last tip today is to do with strokes in Illustrator, and that is to do with being aware of the scale stroke effect options. Press Command or Control K to bring up the Illustrator preferences. Now here, you're going to find the scale stroke effect settings. If they're activated, whatever the scale of your shape or your design asset, the stroke is going to remain the same weight. So in my case here, that's 80 points. But if I go back into the settings and I turn off the scale stroke setting option, the shape's going to be scaled up or down in proportion. the stroke weight is changing according to the size of the shape itself. Now this is something designers sometimes forget, so it's a friendly reminder in today's video. I hope you learned something today in this short but sweet tutorial about strokes in Illustrator. And if you want to keep learning essential skills about graphic design theory, and so much more, make sure to subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Like and share my videos on social media, and of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.